Good morning, students. We'll be doing the third portion of the chapter Life Processes. We have done nutrition and respiration already. Today we are going to begin the third life process, which is transportation. As the word itself is signifying its meaning, that movement of substances from one part of the organism to another. In multicellular organisms, whether plants or animals, transportation is extremely essential. We are going to begin with transportation in plants first. When you talk about plants, we need to first know that what exactly do we need to transport. In plants, majorly we have to transport two things. One is water from the roots to all parts of the plants, especially to the leaves, because water is one of the raw materials for photosynthesis, and leaves contain stomata through which water transpires and helps in bringing rainfall to maintain the water cycle also. The second thing that the plants need to transport is food. Food, as we all have already done, food is prepared in the leaves, and from the leaves it needs to be transported to each and every cell, because living cells require food for their survival. So for transportation in plants, we have a specific tissue known as the vascular tissue. We may also call it vascular bundle. There are two components of the vascular tissue, the xylem and the phloem. The xylem transports water and minerals, and phloem transports food. The xylem and the phloem both are two concentric pipes, with the outer pipe phloem and the inner one is xylem. Now, in order to understand transportation of water and minerals through xylem, let's consider the plant. As you can see in the diagram, the soil is where water is present, and this water present in the soil is not pure water. It contains dissolved minerals, minerals which are required for the growth of the plant. The root hair of the root is in direct contact with the soil, and these cells are living cells with an active plasma membrane. So water from the soil moves into the roots by the process of osmosis, and the reason behind movement of water is the concentration difference of ions. The water present in the soil has a higher concentration of ions, and that present inside the root cells has a lower concentration of the same nutrients, because these are the nutrients which are required for the growth of the plants. So that is the reason why water moves from the soil into the root hair. Now, from the root hair, the water is able to reach the roots, because all these cells are living cells, and once it enters into the xylem, see this inner pipe, this is the xylem. And xylem is a tissue which is totally made up of dead cells, the xylem tracheids and xylem vessels. So the movement of water upwards has to be guided by the external physical forces, because biology will not work. The cells are not living, so diffusion or osmosis will not take place. Now we have to understand how the water moves upwards in xylem if there is no biology happening. The major physical force which helps in upward movement of water through the xylem is the suction pull. And this suction pull is exerted by the air. Now, from where does this air come? See, children, all of you know that the leaves have millions of stomatas, these openings through which you can see the water moving out. These are stomatas. And once the process of photosynthesis occurs in the leaves, then there is deficiency of water in the upper portions of the xylem, and all the water has evaporated through transpiration. So the upper xylems here, they are empty, means having no water, and all of you know that air enters into all the empty spaces. So through these stomatas, the air happens to enter the xylem tissue. And once the air enters the xylem, it moves through the xylem and helps in exerting the suction pull to pull the water upwards into the xylem. So basically talking, the upward movement of water is due to the suction pull. And the suction pull is exerted by the air. And air is able to move into the xylem as a result of the process of transpiration. So, putting it together, transpiration is the major driving force behind upward movement of water in a plant, which is also known as ascent of sap. So, if you trace the path of water, the water from the soil, moves into the root hair. From the root hair, it enters into the root xylem. From the root xylem, into the stem xylem. From the stem xylem, it enters into the leaf. So this is the path of the water. And then finally, it moves out through the stomata.